and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on enthalpy. Enthalpy is denoted by the symbol H and is a measure of the total internal energy of a system. Delta H, or a change in enthalpy, is the energy gained or lost by a system in the form of heat under constant pressure. Remember that the energy change, delta E, is equal to Q plus W, with Q being the heat component and W being the work component. At constant pressure, no work is done. So at constant pressure, the value of W is zero, which means that the change in energy is comprised entirely of the heat component Q. And so the change in enthalpy, or delta H, is equal to the internal energy change of a system, or delta E, at constant pressure, or Q sub P. Enthalpy, like energy, is a state function and depends only on the initial and final states of the system. Oftentimes you see the change in enthalpy, or delta H, written with a chemical reaction to specify the enthalpy change for that reaction. And in this case, what the reaction is saying is that for every 1 mole of C6H12O6 that reacts with 6 moles of oxygen and produces 6 moles of CO2 and 6 moles of water, 2,816 kilojoules per mole of heat are released. So the sign of delta H tells us whether reaction as written is exothermic or endothermic. A positive value of delta H means the reaction as written is endothermic, where a negative value of delta H means the reaction as written is exothermic. The other thing to remember is that enthalpy is an extensive property, and that means it's independent of the sample size. So delta H, as written for this equation, equals negative 2,816 kilojoules per mole of reaction. And this is always the case when delta H is written alongside a reaction. The enthalpy change for the reverse reaction is of the same magnitude but opposite sign. So if we flip this reaction and write it as 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives us C6H12O6 plus 6 moles of oxygen, the delta H value for this reaction is a positive 2,816 kilojoules. And also, it's important to remember that the enthalpy change for a reaction depends on the states of the products and the reactants. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.